Advertising networks are tracking users across the internet to collect as much information about them as possible and then use this data to target them with ads. Historically, this has been done by using different methods. Mainly cookies, small text files that are stored in the user's web browser that websites can access to recognize users. Other methods include flash cookies, a variation of traditional cookies using the flash plugin, and fingerprinting, which tries to identify users using traits like their screen resolution, installed fonts, or browser add-ons. But since most browsers started to integrate tracking protections and many users install privacy and blocking add-ons, these methods have become less effective. Additionally, these tracking methods have always been criticized for being invasive, and recently, politicians in the US and Europe started investigations to carefully examine companies who use targeted ads and trade user data. For these reasons, even advertising giant Google realized something has to change. Going by the name TURTLEDOVE, here is Google's concept for the future of online advertising. Google announced their web browser Chrome will stop supporting third-party cookies, the ones usually coming from advertisers, by no later than early 2022. Currently, together with the World Wide Web Consortium, or W3C, they are trying to find solutions for the future of online advertising. One proposed concept is based on two uncorrelated requests, then locally executed decision on victory, in short, TURTLEDOVE. This means Google is proposing a system where user profiles for targeting ads are no longer kept on advertiser servers, but inside each user's browser. This local profile can then only be accessed anonymously by advertisers and can be changed and deleted by users. The two uncorrelated requests in the title of the concept come from two independent requests the browser makes. One contextual ad request containing the URL of the website accessed. This is already used today. It is, for example, how DuckDuckGo displays ads. They only use the current context, meaning the current search, and no other information. Which brings us to the second, separate request, which indicates an advertiser-identified interest that cannot be tied to any browsing behavior. This second request can also happen at another time than while loading the website where the ad will appear. Google explains how these advertiser-identified interests could be created with this example. The website WeReallyLikeShoes.com sells shoes online. Whenever a new user accesses the website, it tells their browser to assign them to the interest group WeReallyLikeShoes Shopper. If the user searches for running shoes or dress shoes, the website also assigns them to the interest group WeReallyLikeShoes Running Shoes or Dress Shoes. This could theoretically be as detailed as possible, but TURTLEDOVE mentions that targeting groups that are too small could be disabled to retain privacy. If the online shopper buys new shoes, they might get sorted into the groups WeReallyLikeShoes Buyer or otherwise into the group WeReallyLikeShoes Cart Abandoned. So now that we have the two requests, let's look at the locally executed decision mentioned in TURTLEDOVE. Today, advertising spots are often allocated based on very quick auctions that happen during the milliseconds a website is loading. The advertiser willing to spend the most usually gets the spot. Under TURTLEDOVE, these auctions would happen in the user's browser, so the browser would actually tell the website who won the auction. The victory in TURTLEDOVE is the winning ad which finally gets displayed in the browser. So far, TURTLEDOVE is a concept only, but I think the idea of doing as much as possible on device is interesting. Obviously, the system will have to be examined by independent experts, and Google is already experimenting with improvements from recent feedback. Since the Google-owned Chrome browser is the most used web browser by far, and Google also owns one of the largest advertising networks, it is necessary to question Google's intentions and carefully evaluate the results once the W3C has agreed on what the future of online advertising should be.